channel.
Alright, so today we're on day 5 of our trip. We are exiting San Rafael Swell. We did Behind the Reef Trail, I believe that's what it's called. Pretty tough trail, definitely not meant for a trailer. We did it anyway. I would not recommend doing it. We made it. Say hiker designed a very well designed trailer. It was on some pretty off camber stuff yesterday that made me a little nervous. Made the wife way more nervous than me. And I'm not sure of the plan tonight. I'm not sure where we're headed tonight. Some trails today and find a camp on one of the trails. So we are heading into Bell Canyon right now.
Hell's bells.
All right, a little bit of off-camber stuff. Trailer sticking up on top.
Ugh, frog.
Over that rock. Very narrow trail and a lot of spots. Enjoying no snow today.
Are you?
Yeah.
I love it.
I mean, it's cool, but it's cold.
It's still cold out there.
Yeah. The
snow just makes it so pretty.
I'm happy that there's not snow on the trail. We've done quite a few trails this trip in the snow.
It was awesome.
It was very cool. Going up that grade was super cool.
I don't remember this at all.
Cool.
I was just through here in October.
Huh. Sunny day today, first real sunny day since we've been on the road. And as usual, our group is waiting for us again. All right, so that's the Henry Mountains off in the distance.
All right, Dad.
Factory Butte's directly in front of us right now, off in the distance. They take a left when we come out of the wash. Bit of articulation. Go up the hill.
So the north end of Behind the Reef Trail gets pretty...
Behind the Reef
Trail. It's pretty smooth. It turns into decent, smooth, sandy, or not really, but sandy. Anybody looking at one of these hiker trailers, off-road trailers, highly recommend the airbag system for the suspension. It's much more customizable. You can, if you add more weight, you can add a little more air to the airbags and it still give it the really smooth ride. And you can also lower it down, take the air out of the airbags to get it in your garage. Mine fits in my garage, but my roof rack has been altered a little bit. It's 2 inches lower than the normal roof racks on their trailers.
That's all right.
But I do have solar panels sitting. I do have a Rhino rack sitting on top of the factory rack, solar panels sitting on top of that. So I think if you didn't have that stuff on your trailer, you'd still be able to get into the garage. County road now, so it's smooth sailing.
Hanksville's fine?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay.
That works.
So
we should be turning around and going that way? Okay. Time to say goodbye to these guys. They got to go home. We're going to keep exploring for another day or two. And we will see these guys on the next one.
Yeah.
All right. Yep, you too.
See you, man.
Yep. Yep. And Sarah's going with us. We're following Sarah. And a couple more days. She's gonna keep exploring after we're done.
Adventure is life.
Adventure is life.
I'll
give
it here to say it for us.
Adventure is life.
Day five of the trip. We are heading to the Burr Trail now. Definitely driven all over Utah this trip, these 5 days. Two rigs now. We started with four. Two of the group had to break off, go back to work. Be back at work on Monday. To Capitol Reef National Park. Drive to it for a little bit. So we're going to be connecting to the Burr Trail about halfway through it. This road is notable road. Takes you on the back side of getting ready to turn onto the Burr Trail. Switchbacks. Almost. We're not quite to switchbacks yet. Pretty smooth road. Oh yeah, I see him. I'm sure there's turnouts.
Oh, was he going up or down?
He's coming down. Yeah, this trail's wide enough. Most of it looks like it's wide enough we can get out of the way. Burr Trail Switchbacks. This is cool.
Where's the snow?
Yeah, this would be really cool driving up in the snow too.
soon as we get to the bottom of this, we might find a canyon.
Right now. Oh my god.
Your hair's covered up. You're fine.